Hi people, in this video I will show you how to draw tilesets like this. I am bad at drawing and I am even worse at making videos. But please, bear with me for a while. First of all, you have to draw tile paths that differ between tiles. I use Krita for digital painting. It's a very nice open source program and it has this seamless view, which helps a lot when drawing tiles. For example, for side view tileset like we are doing now, you'll need tile center, tile side, tile top, tile bottom. Four corners, two outer corners and two inner corners. In our case, top and bottom differ, but the sides are the same. While I'm drawing, I'll tell you about TilePipe. It's a little tool I've made to help work with tilesets. TilePipe goes for tilesets pipeline, so it's made to speed up iterations while working on tiles. You can download it on each IO. It's made with Godot game engine and has direct export to Godot. The tile paths that I am drawing are pretty similar to what I would draw for Tileset, but I didn't know about it when I started to make this tool. The main difference in workflow is that you don't have to position anything in the program UI. You position everything in your graphic editor, Krita in this case. TilePipe has also another composition mode, which is called Generation from Quarters, which I won't cover in this video. It also has some other life improving features, and I have plans for more. For example, you can set up tile positions in your tile set by editing the template, which is also an image. Or you can randomize the resulting tiles a bit by adding to the input image some variants of your tile paths. So after we have drawn all the tiles we need, we can open TilePipe and see the UI. Select overlay generation type and a tile preset. Check out the example. In the example, you can see how you should position your tile paths. These tile paths position are specific for the selected preset. Also, all of the built-in examples are included in the download. So we can open one in Krita and see how to position our tiles. It's not that hard at all, just place them every 16 pixels. Or what is your tile size? Next, we need to open the tiles we've drawn and resize canvas. Now it's a little bit copy-pasting time. After you have positioned your tile paths properly, save your texture as PNG file. Then open TilePipe again and load your texture. Voila! You have a tileset. At this point we can fine-tune how the tiles are composed. For overlay composition we have two main settings. It is overlay amount and merge amount. Drag the sliders around and see how the tiles changed. When you're happy with your tiles, you need to save the resulting texture and Godot resource, if you are going to use it in Godot. To be able to use it in Godot, you need to have both texture and Godot tileset inside Godot project. Now let's open Godot editor and create tile map. As a tileset, we can load our generated tileset, and right now we can just draw your map and be happy with it. The tiles may be not perfect, but that's all I can draw. So while playing around, I've noticed that something wrong with the sides of the tiles. The sides look just a little bit off. When I was drawing the tiles, I thought that the sides will be a little bit smaller than the full tile. Let's see how can we fix them. So we need to reopen Krita. After zooming in on the side part, I've noticed that it looks in another direction. So I flip it and save the texture again. Now I will open TilePipe again and press the button Reload Texture. The tile set texture regenerates automatically. Now I have to save it again. Now if I reopen the Godot editor, I will see the tile map updated. And that's it. I can now draw my map with my generated tile set. I hope you like the program and the video. Have a nice day.